Hey guys, how you doing today? It is Wednesday afternoon. I'm sitting out here in the car at lunch. Excuse me. I put a comment up on Facebook before saying that I actually have no ideas for videos for this channel right now. And I don't. I'm totally empty. People have been throwing ideas out there, and Andy had asked about, you know, trials and tribulations between Tomoko and myself, as far as, you know, troubles we would have being an interracial couple. And, you know, to be honest, we don't really have any troubles. And then he asked, you know, not even in the beginning, and no, we really didn't. And, you know, this is gonna break a lot of images that a lot of people have about Japan. But, you know, a foreigner marrying a Japanese really isn't that big of a deal. I mean, you hear so much stuff like, you know, Japanese parents don't want the gaijin in the family, blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm sure there are parents like that. But that would be the exact same as back in the States, you know, like a white family wouldn't want, you know, the son or daughter coming home with a black person. Or reverse, a black family wouldn't want their son or daughter coming home with a white person. It's the same thing here. You know, I'm sure there are people that are against it. And, oh, wow, I should turn that music off, shouldn't I? I'm sure there are people against it, but, you know, we never had that problem. And I never had that problem with my first wife. My first wife's mother, you know, God rest her soul, she just died last year. She wasn't very fond of me, but I don't think it was the foreigner thing. I don't think she would have been happy with anybody that my wife married, or my ex-wife, I should say. And Tomoko, you know, when, you know, we dated for a while before I met her family, but, you know, that's normal. A lot of people date, you know, no matter, you know, which country you're in, you date before you meet the, before you finally meet the parents. And, the first time I actually met her mother was at her father's funeral. And, at that time, we were still dating, but we weren't to the point where I'd meet her family. And, I actually, you know, her father was in the hospital with cancer. And he was going down really quick, and she wanted me to meet him before he passed away. Now, by the time I got to meet him, he was already in an invalid state, and I don't even think he knew that I was in the room. but I went to the hospital, and I met her father, and he died that evening. Now, her mother wasn't there at the time. And when I went to the funeral, we both agreed that that wasn't the proper time to, you know, out our relationship. You know, you don't want to, you know, walk into the funeral and say, oh, this is my boyfriend. I went to the layout, and I met her mother and her brother there. And, but we, like I said, we didn't talk about our relationship at all. She just told them that I was her English teacher. And then, wasn't too long after that, I guess, we decided to, you know, meet the family. So she took me over when her brother was home. Her brother lives up in Tokyo, and he was home for a weekend. So, we went to her house, and I met her brother, and met her mom, and, you know, wasn't anything strange, nothing weird, nobody seemed out of place. And when we decided to get married, you know, there wasn't anything said out of line. I get along with her mom and brother just fine. You know, I hate to break a lot of images that people have of Japan, but this place really isn't as psycho as a lot of people think it is. You know, just like I was saying in my racism video, you know, racism does exist here. I can't say it doesn't. But racism exists anywhere you go in the world. Okay. And I don't know why people seem to think that this place sticks out more than anywhere else. Okay. Now, especially Americans, and, you know, Americans have a lot of balls to talk about Japan being racist. I mean, come on, guys. You know, Japan doesn't have a history of, you know, picking up Whitey and hanging him from a tree. So, come on. You know, racism exists anywhere you go. And, you know, a lot of the things that I pointed out in my previous racism video, or on the topic of racism, you know, people not sitting next to you on the train, you know, a lot of it has to do with being shy and being afraid of being spoken to and not being able to talk back. And, you know, a lot of people can say that I'm drinking the Kool-Aid over here, or, you know, I'm a Japan apologist, but I'm not. You know, I've lived here for 22 years. I've talked to these people. I've asked people, you know, why wouldn't you sit next to somebody on a train? And, you know, they'd be, oh, you know, I'd be afraid. You know, what if he talked to me? I wouldn't be able to talk back. So, you know, I'm not basing any of my views on just a feeling. You know, I mean, I've lived here so long, and I've talked to a lot of people. Anyway, we're totally off the track. Tomoko and I never really had any problems. No, we sure didn't. And again, I'm digging for anything to talk about with you guys. You know, the year started, and I've only put up 2 videos so far this year. But, you know, I'm kind of noticing all around the J-Vlog community, it's kind of slow right now. Victor's not putting up videos at his normal pace. You know, Sonny seems to be back here and there. It just seems like everybody's slowed down this year. I don't know what it is. But, you know, when I get up and running again, I'll be up and running. And, you know, there are a couple people that have been asking me to show my my guitar gear, and I've been meaning to do that. I really need to do that. I'm not going to promise it, but I'll try to do that tonight when I get home. I'm going to see Joe tomorrow, so I'm going to be, you know, breaking my stuff out, see what I'm taking with me. So I'll do that. All right, guys. So for now, we'll leave it at that, and I'll talk to you guys later. Don't let your meatloaf.